Yochaved Yirmiyahu, a servant of our Lord, Adonai Yeshua of Nazareth, our Messiah. Mercy, grace, peace, and love be yours in abundance. Our Father, thou art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our sins, as we have forgiven those who have sinned against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is your kingdom, power, and glory, forever. Amen. Well, I woke up this morning and the sun was red. I mean, we're talking cherry red. I guess there's some fires in the area and some clouds and such, and it was red. And my wife, you know, showed it to me, and I was like, wow, it's pretty incredible, you know? I mean, obviously it's not red everywhere in the world, but this morning it was certainly an eye-opener, you know? Listening to some Bach again, waiting for my tea to steep, and here's my cat, Leo. He's peeking out the window. Leo, say good morning. Anyway, so I'm going to start with this and end with this. And there's a lot of stuff in between. So if you want to watch this a few times, it might be a good idea. Denying ourselves and picking up our cross and following our Lord requires our submission to His Spirit and daily discipline, applying His word in prayer and in actions. We all have different levels of hormones and weaknesses and pride and self-centeredness. We all have senses and natural drive to indulge. So remember, I'm going to finish with that one too, just so that we remember, you know, even though we have the Holy Spirit, power and great faith, and we can move mountains and all that, we need to remember that as powerful as God is, we can still be weak, we can still fall, and we need to love and care and pray for one another and support one another in a genuine way, in a sincere way, in a way in which we don't really do very much. Not most of us. No, not really. Okay. Let us boldly move forward and let go of selfishness and vanity. Yes. Are we commanded to be holy as He is holy? Yes. In addition to being cleansed and purified and praying fervently, we are commanded to be generous and to give cheerfully. Yes, this is right. So many are the grievings and the quenchings of His Spirit. This is not good. May we be sobered. May we pray and receive correction and repent. The desires of the flesh, sin that is in us at work, and Satan, of course, and demons and all that, you know, all of these are preventing many of us from giving up comforts and luxuries. This is true. So many souls are in need of salvation, and so many ministries are willing to go and share the gospel. Yeah, so that means we either need to be doing more or praying and supporting financially those who are able and willing to go and do all that God has commissioned them to do. Whosoever is ashamed and renders themselves unfit has rejected the truth and eternal life with Elohim. They shall be judged at the great white throne of judgment. The joyfully, eternally obedient sons of Elohim have received the truth. They rejoice in the truth. They walk in the truth. They share the truth with love, kindness, and grace by faith. They freely have received and they freely give. They act out of a fully comprehended understanding that they have total victory and triumph over Satan, and they rejoice greatly. This truth has set them free. prayer, fasting, and casting out demons. This shall escalate in many nations because of those who answer the call and go and do with all of their heart, soul, mind, and strength what God has commanded of them. Our Heavenly Father is good, and He gives good gifts, and He has an eternal dwelling for us, for which we are to enjoy with Him forever. And we have our bridegroom, and we're His bride, and we're vessels of honor for a spirit that stirs in us. If we would just listen and surrender. And remember, I'm going to finish with that same piece that I began with. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. The whole earth is filled with his glory. Amen. Okay. Before the completion of miracles that multiply and salvation spreading like wildfire, pride, greed, fear, ignorance, and division within the anointed ministries must take place. Need to get rid of those stuff. That all that just it needs to go. Kingdom, power, and glory. Newness, rest. Wow. Contentment and peace. Not because we have a lot of stuff or we can pat ourselves on the back for our own righteousness, but just knowing that he loves us and that we're joyfully obeying him every day, whatever he's commanding us to do. We're going to have positions of authority. We're going to have immortal bodies. Bridegroom and bride united forever. Hallelujah. There's a plumb line. Yeah. There's a line in the sand that's drawn. And, you know, right now is spiritual preparedness. It's time to enter the banquet, the wedding banquet. Many have a knowledge about God. They do. But by name, he knows them not. They kept learning, but they never acquired the knowledge of the truth. Many that have and shall since abandonment are those that obeyed not the Holy Spirit. All sins are forgivable except the sin against the Spirit. Many are called, few are chosen. By faith, we who have chosen to remain in the upward and forward momentum and to remain in one accord, we rejoice greatly. For this agape impetus dunamis, that's the name of my evangelist ministry. Oh, and by the way, these t-shirts here that I make, I give away for free. So, you know, you can contact me on Messenger and let me know if you'd like one. I have some new ones coming in, sizes small, medium, and large. His spirit has and is and shall continue to work miracles in and through us. You know, those whom he ministers to through us, they are our crown and joy. They are our crown and joy. Oh, how we are filled with his love and compassion. And as we pray and as we go and do anything that we do so out of love, as we are clothed with the garments of love, as we have the full armor on, the fruit of the Spirit in us, welling up and spilling over. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Unity, divinity, and a progressive fulfillment of the Great Commission. Having been liberated from ignorance, arrogance, guilt, confusion, and anxiety, may we cheerfully pour time
and resources into one another's ministries so that we who are his bride would set his truth in the sunlight with exceedingly great joy, with great bold faith, love, joy, yes, and we shall behold, many receive faith, sight, salvation, healing, and restoration. Now, we have to clear, no, now we have clear orders to obey. So, on one hand, I'm very joyful to give all of this information, but on the other hand, now you're responsible. For now we have clear orders to obey. God forbid if we disobey. Because it is a sin to break any of the commandments, but it is a great sin also to know the good to do and do it not. Choose wisely. Know fully who you are. We need to know fully who we are and know all that we have. And with all that we have, we need to go and do all that we have been commanded to do. This makes sense. So we need to get rid of ignorance. We need to get rid of arrogance. We need to get rid of guilt and confusion and anxiety. These things gotta go. And we can pray for whatever it is that we want to pray for. We can say, search my heart, O Lord. Know any wicked way in me. Purge me, purify me, cleanse me, wash me, clean. Give me correction, direction, and instruction as you lead me by the power of your Spirit, as I don't just read the Word of God, but as I look into the Word of God, as I ask and seek and knock with all of my heart. This is an attitude of repentance, an attitude of wanting to be a humble, joyful, obedient servant of God forever. Elohim is holy, and it is his will that all of his sons do away with completely and let go of all of these things that stem from ignorance and anxiety that multiply into confusions and cause people to limit themselves to live these lives that Satan wants them to live. It's very sad and unfortunate, and it should not be. It is his will that all of his sons rejoice in the full freedom that they have with great joy and come and worship him in spirit and in truth, and to have successful ministries full of good works. Now, we're going to go back to the one that we began with so we can remind ourselves. Denying ourselves. That's right. Denying ourselves and picking up our cross and following our Lord requires our submission to his Spirit and daily discipline, applying his word in prayer and in actions. We all have different levels of hormones and weaknesses, pride and self-centeredness. We all have senses and a natural drive to indulge. But we need to truly come before him and say, Lord, eternity with you, glory, this is what you have beckoned my heart to want, to be with you forever, to be loved by you, to not be eternally separated from you. And my order is obedience. So please help me to be your joyfully obedient, loving, righteous servant that comes to you and knows that you not only love and care about us, but you have so many good gifts for us. And they are not of this world, even as we are not of this world. I'm going to have my tea now and pray myself, because we all need to pray. and I'm going to read the word of God. Oh, yes. I was going to read this part here. The Lord looks down from heaven and sees the whole human race. From his throne, he observes all who live on the earth. That's a portion from Psalms. Let us love one another fervently and pray for one another, and let us give into one another's ministries sacrificially, wholeheartedly, generously, cheerfully, so that his will be done in us and through us on the earth as he wills it from heaven. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the name of Yeshua of Nazareth, we pray. Amen.